Welcome to Stories, Shlokas, Sanskar. According to Sri Vidya Upasana, Sri Lalita Tripura Sundari is the ultimate Shakti in this universe. Today, we share the story of how Sri Lalitambika incarnated and how she killed Bhandasura. The story is described in the poetic form as Lalitambal Shobanam, which is recited by many devotees every day. The story is also told in the Lalita Sahasranamam. Sage Agastya once performed penance and Lord Vishnu appeared in his form as Haygriva, the god of knowledge. Sage Agastya asked Haygriva to share the story of Lalita Tripura Sundari. Lord Haygriva explained, after the death of Sati, Shiva took up Samadhi in Himalayas. Sati was reborn as Parvati, the daughter of mountain king Himavat. A demon, Tarakasur, troubled the sages and devas. It was believed that the son of Shiva will kill this demon. As Shiva was in meditative state, devas approached Manmatha, the god of love, for help. They asked Manmatha to influence Shiva and he would beget a son from Parvati. Manmatha arrived at Himalayas and aimed flower arrows at Lord Shiva. Shiva was moved from his samadhi and he looked lovingly at Parvati. Then he noticed Manmatha and soon realized why this had happened. Shiva's third eye opened and Manmatha was burnt to ashes as a punishment of disturbing Shiva's samadhi. Chitrakarma gave the ashes of Manmatha a male form. He initiated the boy into Shatarudra mantra to please Lord Shiva. Pleased with the boy's rigorous penance, Lord Shiva appeared before him. The boy asked for a strange boon. Anyone who fights against me should immediately lose half of his strength and that strength should be added to my strength, he said. Lord Shiva granted this boon. Lord Brahma, who was witnessing this, was unhappy and said, Bhand, Bhand. From then, the boy came to be known as Bhand. Since Bhand was born from Shiva's anger, he possessed qualities of a demon. Shukracharya and thousands of powerful demons lived with Bhandasur as their king in Shonitapura. Bhandasur had thousands of chariots, soldiers, elephants and horses. The demons performed penance and worship of Lord Shiva and became powerful and prosperous. Lord Vishnu sent Maya and beautiful Apsaras to entice the demons who fell for this trap and gave up worship and sacrifices. Meanwhile, sage Narad advised Indra to worship Parashakti in order to defeat Bhandasura and regain his past glory. At the banks of River Ganga, the Devas worshipped Devi Parashakti. As Devas continued the worship, this news reached Bhandasura. He rushed to the foothills of Himalayas. Devas now constructed the auspicious Agni Kund fire pit and offered flesh from their hands and legs. They proceeded to jump into the sacrificial fire, submitting themselves to Parashakti. From the fire pit, Sri Lalita Tripura Sundari, seated on the Sri Chakra, appeared. She had the brilliance of crores of rising suns. Devas praised Devi with Lalita Stavaraja. Brahma, Vishnu, Shiva, Durga, Ganesh, Kartikeya, Narada, sages, celestial beings, Gandharvas, Yakshas, Yoginis arrived for the darshan of Devi Sri Lalita Tripura Sundari. Vishwakarma built a unique capital for Devi called Srinagar. It had residence for ministers, enclosure for elephants, horses and a royal palace. The throne was made of wish-fulfilling Chintamani gems and precious stones. The celestial wedding of Lalita Tripura Sundari and Kameshwara was conducted in presence of Devas, Rishis and celestial beings. Kameshwara is a form of Lord Shiva. The crowning ceremony of Sri Kameshwara and Sri Lalita Devi was performed. Brahma praised Devi as Kameshwari and Kamakshi, who granted the desires of her devotees by her mere glance. One day, sage Narad requested Lalita Parmeshwari to annihilate Bhandasura and put an end to his atrocities. Sri Lalita Parmeshwari ascended the Sri Chakra chariot and started to the battlefield. There were many Siddhi goddesses, Yoginis, Sri Chakra Shaktis, Nitya goddesses on the Sri Chakra chariot. Sampatkari was the captain of elephant regiment. Sri Dandanatha, Varahi Devi, was a commander-in-chief of the army. Sri rode the Kiri Chakra chariot. Sri Shamala Devi, also known as Mantrini, is the minister of Sri Lalita Parameshwari. Sri Mantrini rode the Gaya Chakra, which made musical sounds. As the Sri Chakra, Gaya Chakra and Kiri Chakra chariots started moving together, earth trembled and there was a tremendous uproar in the Shakti Sena. The Shaktis started killing the demons on a massive scale. Sri Bala, the 9-year-old daughter of Sri Lalitambika, killed 30 sons of Bhandasur in the battlefield. Shamala Devi, Dandanatha and Sri Lalitambika praised Bala for her bravery. Bhandasura's brothers Vishukra and Vishanga and the nephews were killed. Devi created Ganesha with the help of Kameshwara to remove the blockages. Using Narayana Astra, Sri Lalitambika destroyed the whole army of Bhandasura. Finally, Sri Lalitambika killed Bhandasura with the Mahakameshwara Astra. The Devas and celestial beings praised Sri Lalita Tripurasundari. It is believed worship of Sri Lalitambika will lead to the fulfillment of all the wishes of the devotees. Devotees worship Devi by chanting the beautiful hymn Lalita Sahasranamam, the worship of Sri Chakra and Meru. Do subscribe to our channel Stories, Shlokas, Sanskar and share this video with family and friends.